Good morning, students of Standard 7. This is Ma'am Nancy, teaching mathematics. Today's chapter 2, multiplication and division of integers. First, let us revise what you have learnt in the previous standard. That's addition and subtraction of integers. First one, 5 plus 7, that will give us 12. Second, 10 plus bracket minus 5. Open the bracket, that's 10 minus 5 will give us 5. Plus into minus, minus. Minus 4 plus 3, the sum is in minus. Minus 4 plus 3 will give answer minus 1 because it's a minus sum and sign of the greater number. Fourth one, minus 7 plus bracket minus 2. Open the bracket. Minus 7 plus into minus will give you minus. So minus 7 minus 2, actually it is addition. So 7 plus 2 gives us 9. And sign of the greater number, that is 7, so it has minus sign, so you need to write minus. Fifth one, plus 8 minus bracket plus 3. So open the bracket, that gives us 8 minus 3, that means answer 5. Minus into plus, minus. Your plus into minus and your minus into plus. So whether it is plus into minus or minus into plus, the answer will remain. The answer will take the sign of the greater number. Sixth one, plus 8 minus bracket minus 3. Open the bracket, minus into minus will give you plus. So that's 8 plus 3, answer is 11. Before we proceed further, let us understand the rules to add, subtract. In this case, we'll proceed with multiplication. Today we will restrict ourselves in this video only for multiplication, and we'll also will be solving practice set only 8. So the first rule says the product of two positive integers is a positive integer. It means plus 5 into plus 5 will give me 25. Positive integer into positive integer gives me answer positive integer. Or we could also write that as 5 into 5 gives us 25. Second rule, the product of a positive integer and a negative integer is a negative integer. It means plus 3 into minus 2 will give me answer as minus 6. Why? Because plus into minus, minus. Or it could also be written as 3 into minus 2. So 3 2s are 6. And plus into minus, minus. There is no mention of sign here. But we all know that when there is no sign mentioned, it is accepted as plus. Third one, the product of two negative integers is a positive integer. It means when you get two numbers multiplied with negative signs, minus 4 into minus 4. So that gives you plus 16 because minus into minus, plus. So we need to remember plus into plus is plus. Plus into minus or minus into plus, your answer will always be in minus. And minus into minus, plus. So these three things are very easy to remember. Plus into plus is naturally plus. Plus into minus or minus into plus will give you answer in minus. And the last one, minus into minus will become plus. So also we solve the second one. Write a number in each of the brackets to obtain answer 3 in each operation. It's like a game. Okay, 3 is in the center. So wherever there is a blank bracket, okay, you need to write down the number. So when you write a number there, your answer should give 3. See, let's start with first one. 4 minus what will give me 3? Yeah, that's right. 4 minus 1 will give me 3. Now 7 plus minus 4. It's already given. So 7 plus minus 4 plus into minus minus. So see, 7 minus 4 will give me 3. So that's the answer here. And the next one, minus 6 plus. What should I put in the bracket here? So I will get 3. Oh yes, you're right. It is 9. Okay. So these two, that is 1, 2 and 3, you will do it for yourself. Okay, that's how we'll come to know, oh yes, you have done it. Okay, now we proceed for practice set 8. Practice set 8 is multiply using the rules. So the first one says that minus 5 into minus 7 will give me answer 35. And how's that? Let's work that out. So minus 5 into minus 7. First, you just know your tables. So first, just write down 5 sevens are gives me how much? Oh yes, 35. Minus into minus, plus. Second one, minus 9 into 6. So first, 9 sixes are. How much is 9 sixes are? That's right, 54. Minus into plus will give me answer in minus. 9 into minus 4. So 9 fours are? Oh yes, that's right. 9 fours are 36. Plus into minus? Minus. Next one, 8 into minus 7. 8 into minus 7. 8 sevens are? Yes, that's right. 56. Plus into minus? Minus. Minus 124 into minus 1. Oh my God, this is such a big number. Not at all. 124 into 1, that means self. So we'll give 124 or 124. Minus into minus, plus. Sixth one, minus 12 into minus 7. Minus 12 into minus 7 will give me how much? Yes, that's right. 12 sevens are 84. Minus into minus, plus. Seventh one, minus 63 into minus 7. That's a big number. You could multiply in your working column and find out what's the answer. Minus 63 into minus 7 will give me 441. 441 minus into minus is plus. Minus 7 into 15 will give me how much? 105. Okay, and plus into minus, minus. So here we have applied all the three rules, whether it is plus into plus or plus into minus or minus into plus and minus into minus. With these sums, I guess you must have all understood the complete concept of applying the three rules. The first rule says positive integer into positive integer will give you an answer in positive integer. Second rule says that a positive into negative integer or a negative into positive integer will always give you answer in negative integer. And the third rule says that a negative integer into a negative integer will always give you answer in positive integer. Hope children, you have understood these concepts. Try to work out more sums. Complete these sums in your maths notebook. You prepare a notebook. Do not go out to buy a notebook. You could have your teachers must have already informed you. In the last class, I have already said that make pages, old book pages of last year and assemble them, but please preserve it so that you do not have to rush through once we begin with our regular classes. Preserve it, file it up if you do not have a new notebook. And keep practicing, make more new sums. Maths is always a fun. You play with it and you will enjoy. Do not tax yourself. All the sums are very easy. We are restricting in this video for only multiplication. In our next video, we will be dealing with division of integers. So I would like you all to just go through, if at all you have a textbook at home, please go through the rules of division of integers. Or even you can just Google it out from the PDF. Textbook PDF will be available in Google. So you could also download that and just go through the rules and regulations so that it's easy for you to understand. I hope in this video you must have understood. Still, if you have any doubts, there's no problem in explaining again repeatedly. You just put it into the comment box, or you can just send it through in your classwork assignments across that these are my doubts. And I will always revert back in due course of time. If not immediately, but surely I will revert back and clear your doubts as much as possible. If at all something remains where you need to physically be explained, I will convey to your teachers, or else when we meet, I will surely see that it is being solved. So enjoy this pandemic era. We all are new to it. Be safe, children. Use all your safety measures. Do not get fed up because it's been such a long time that we are going through this pandemic sufferings. But take it as a learning. Take it as a lesson. And also see that what all you could do in this period. What all you can stay at home and you can enjoy. You can bond yourself very well with your family. Okay, all the time that is being given, keep bonding with your siblings, that is your brothers and sisters, mother, father, grandmother, anyone who is there. Okay, do not plunge out, do not venture out to explore. Keep yourself very, very safe and use all the precautionary measures that is being said. Okay, the hygiene, the washing hands, which is already being taught to you in our Dominic Savio. So wishing you all the best. Happy maths class for today. Enjoy. Any doubts, please revert back to me in comment or whatever. Or if even if you have not understood my explanation, please revert it back. I will try to make it more simpler. Thank you very much, children. Have a good day.